Good evening and welcome to our Ash Wednesday service. We will have Holy Communion tonight and also imposition of ashes. So let us begin calling God into our presence. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We turn to our gathering hymn number 349, Ah Holy Jesus. We will sing the first three verses. The love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray the prayer of the day. Good Shepherd, we come to you broken, for we have broken your world. Heal what we have harmed, and make us whole again. Amen. Please be seated. First reading tonight is from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Word of God, love of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel for this evening is from the Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and to kill and destroy. I came that they may have life, and have it abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired hand who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. A hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, the risen Christ. Amen. In the late summer of 1741, George Frederick Handel composed his best known and most successful oratorio. It was first performed in Dublin, Ireland, on April 13th, 1742, with Handel conducting the performance in person. The following year, and virtually every year thereafter, Handel's score has been brought out to the delight of audiences all over the world. The chorus almost everyone recognizes from The Messiah is Hallelujah. For those of us who have performed this masterpiece, there are other choruses which are able to capture our hearts in an even deeper way. There are a couple of those choruses which speak in a profound way to me. One is the final chorus, Worthy is the Lamb that was slain, which ends with the triumphal doxology of blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him, and the resounding Amen. Another chorus was brought to my mind as I read our text for this week. All we like sheep have gone astray. As I thought about our text for this Ash Wednesday, two events drove home the lessons. First, I was shopping at Walmart recently, and for a change, the store wasn't as crowded as I have come to expect. So I wasn't feeling a great need to escape the dangers of a big crowd. I was taking my time. As I was passing the toy department, I noticed a young mother with two children. As mom was shopping, the two kids were busy browsing on their own. And it wasn't long before one of them, a little girl, had disappeared into another aisle. It wasn't long before mom noticed that she was gone. Where is your sister? She asked the other child. Mary Ellen, she called. I couldn't help grinning as Mary Ellen put down the doll that she was admiring and quickly returned to her mother's side. She knew her name. She knew her mother's voice. The combination drew her back to her mother's side. And a few days later, I was at the library for a meeting, and while I was busy gathering stuff I needed for that meeting, I heard a loud voice from the other side of the library. Dad! The voice was ripe with panic. Dad wasn't far away, but the sound of the child's cry brought him there in a hurry. All we like sheep. Isn't it amazing how well we recognize the voices of those we love? Isn't it astounding how much power those voices have over our behavior? It needn't be a parent-child relationship. It works the same with siblings, close friends, even with people in a hospital situation. In a hospital, a nurse quickly begins to recognize the voices of the patients in his or her care. Patients who are heavily sedated will respond to the voice of the person caring for them. When I was in high school, I used to visit the farm where an aunt and uncle raised sheep. One of the things that amazed me in my youthful arrogance and ignorance was how easily that small flock of sheep could be managed. All my uncle would have to do was call the name of an animal, and the animal would lift its head and come to him. All we like sheep. Sheep in Jesus' day were a valuable commodity. Families counted their net worth by counting their sheep. The shepherds were asset managers, and the family would give the herd over to the care of a shepherd. The shepherd would lead the flocks to water and good grazing, protect them from predators, and at the end of the day, lead them back into the safety of the communal sheepfold. And in the morning, the shepherd would call his sheep, and they would follow. As long as sheep stay with the flock, the shepherd can defend them. But sheep can be distracted and become separated from the safety of the flock. It is the same for human beings. Life in this world is filled with distractions. A cell phone ringing while we're driving can put us in a dangerous situation in just seconds. Television programming can distract us from other things we know we should be doing. The opening weekend of fishing season has the power to destroy our concentration at work for days, even weeks. Hunting seasons, sports, dance lessons, and even high school proms can distract us from more important things. People who work with dangerous machinery rely upon safety switches and guards to help protect them from inevitable distractions, which can be as simple as a coworker talking to them. All we like sheep. Jesus recognizes the fact that distractions and other voices can easily cause us to drift away, to get ourselves into trouble, to follow voices which are not the right voices. There are bandits all around us. It is during the worst of those distracting times that our shepherd calls us. He calls us in many ways. It can be something as simple as a wandering child or a wandering parent. It can be something as profound as picking up this book we call the Bible and reading a familiar passage, but hearing the words in a new way. It can be the voice of a doctor telling a patient that everything will be okay. The good news for us is that we have a shepherd. Our shepherd knows everything we need. He leads us to fresh green pastures, sits with us beside still waters. He walks with us through all of our deepest and darkest valleys. He calls us back when we are going astray and guards our souls. All we like sheep. The good news for us is that our shepherd is always minding the gates of our sheepfold. Going out or coming in, his voice will always guide us. All we like sheep. We have surely gone astray, followed the wrong voices at times, been distracted by worldly things. Yet he was willing to die for all of his sheep. His death destroyed our worst enemy. His resurrection secured our greatest hope and need. All we like sheep have gone astray. But Jesus, our shepherd, will always call us back to the fold where we are protected for all eternity. We have turned everyone to his own way, but the Lord has laid on Jesus the iniquity of us all. That shepherd did lay down his life to protect all of his sheep. Blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him that sitteth upon the throne forever. Amen. Let us turn to our next hymn, Savior, Like a Shepherd, Lead Us, number 789 in the Red Book. Church, we enter the time of remembering Jesus' Passover from death to life, and our life in Christ is renewed. We begin this holy season by acknowledging our need for repentance and for God's mercy. We are created to experience joy in communion with God, to love one another, and to live in harmony with creation. But our sinful rebellion separates us from God, our neighbors, and creation, so that we do not enjoy the life our Creator intended. As disciples of Jesus, we are called to a discipline that contends against evil and resists whatever leads us away from the love of God and neighbor. I invite you, therefore, to the discipline of Lent, self-examination and repentance, prayer and fasting, sacrificial giving, and works of love strengthened by the gifts of word and sacrament. Let us continue our journey through these 40 days to the great 3 days of Jesus' death and resurrection. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Most holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another and before the whole company of heaven that we have sinned by our own most grievous fault, in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven. Have mercy on us, O God. We have shut our ears to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit. Have mercy on us, O God. Our past unfaithfulness, the pride, envy, hypocrisy, and apathy that have infected our lives, we confess to you. Have mercy on us, O God. Our self-indulgent appetites and ways and our exploitation of other people, we confess to you. Have mercy on us, O God. Our neglect of human need and suffering and our indifference to the injustice and cruelty, we confess to you. Have mercy on us, O God. Our false judgments, our uncharitable thoughts toward our neighbors, and our prejudice and contempt toward those who differ from us, we confess to you. Have mercy on us, O God. Our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who come after us, we confess to you. Have mercy on us, O God. Restore us, O God, and let your anger depart from us. Hear us, O God, for your mercy is great. Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. May these ashes be a sign of our mortality and penitence, reminding us that only by the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ are we given eternal life. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. This time I invite you to come forward for the imposition of ashes. Remember that you are dust, and to dust you will return. Remember that you are dust, and to dust you will return. Arlene, remember that you are dust, and to dust you will return. Laura, remember that you are dust, and to dust you will return. Remember that you are dust, to dust you will return. Amanda, remember that you are dust, to dust you will return. Accomplish in us, O God, the work of your salvation, that we may show forth your glory in the world. By the cross and passion of your Son, our Savior, bring us with all your saints to the joy of your resurrection. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life.
Amen.
Let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Our petitions will end. Good Shepherd, please respond. Hear our prayer. Lord, we are often stubborn and willfully ignorant of your guidance. Steer us back to your fold and reassure us of your unconditional love. Good Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
You love all that you have made, O Lord, and long for us to tend it as carefully as you would yourself. Endow us with your careful, gentle spirit, and return us to the work of stewardship with which you first entrusted us at creation. Good Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Lord, nothing can separate us from you, not predators, nor dangers, nor death itself. As we remember our own mortality this day, we do so in the sure promise of your ultimate resurrection. Good Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
You restore our souls and anoint our heads with healing oil. Bring all those who long for relief into your secure pasture and into the wholeness of your family. We lift up especially Betty, Alvin and Elvie, Debbie, Jim, Gerald, Frank, Mark, Marty, Russell, Susan, Greg, Chris, Jennifer, James, Ron, Diane, Bill, Stan, Terry, Cindy, Bonnie, Andy and Mary, and Rob and their families. Good Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Blessed are those who dwell in your house forever, O Lord. Draw all your saints together, both living and resurrected, into one great fold, where we hear and know your voice, and where no threat of danger may harm us. Good Shepherd,
hear our prayer.
Gather our prayers as you gather your beloved sheep, O Lord, for we entrust them as we do ourselves to your eternal care. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share the peace. Let us offer a prayer of thanksgiving for the offerings received here tonight and by mail. Let us pray. What we bring before you, O Lord, is insignificant, but we humbly offer what we are able to give anyway. We know that you can multiply any blessing, and we pray you turn these gifts into abundant blessings for your world. In Jesus' name we pray. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus teaches. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Come, all who sin, and lay your burdens before the one with the ability and willingness to carry them. Come to this table, for it has been set so that in receiving the bread and wine, you can leave this place free. Even on this day, we acknowledge that we are bound to sin and yet forgiven. Have your wafers. This is the body of Christ given for you. And cups. It's the blood of Christ shed for you. Body of our Lord Jesus Christ and his precious blood, strengthen and preserve you unto eternal life. Peace be with you. Amen. Let us pray. Blessed Jesus, in this rich meal of grace, you have fed us with your body, the bread of life. Now send us forth to bear your life-giving hope to a world in need. Amen. Please stand for the blessing. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. We turn to our closing hymn, Abide With Me. We will sing verses 1, 3, 4, and 5. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the afflicted, honor all people, love and serve God, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.